Peace be with you, friends. Thank you for joining me today. Organists get used to playing for small crowds, but today being in this empty sanctuary is an even more unique experience. However, I've been thinking a lot today about my spiritual superhero, Mr. Rogers, who said once that the space between the television set and the child at home could become holy ground. And my prayer for today is that this space that connects us through the music that we'll share in this unique way might indeed be a blessing to you to bring a little bit more peace and hope and light than you might have otherwise known this afternoon. That first piece was an arrangement of the wonderful melody by Gustav Holst from The Planets. A lot of times we sing that in churches. I vow to thee, my country, or O God, beyond all praising, a noble, beautiful song of praise. And so today the organ sings songs of praise and also prayer. In this next piece by the French composer Charles-Marie Vidor, you can hear in the beginning and ending flute stops, and in the foundation the warm sort of singing orchestral sounds in the middle. You feel a very spacious, fervent, reverberant prayer. This piece is called Andante Sostenuto, which maybe means something like a piece kind of at a walking tempo that's very sustained and connected. Indeed, a beautiful prayer for us to hear this day. Andante Sostenuto by Charles-Marie Vidor.
Thank you.
Charles-Marie Vidor, among many others, was completely in admiration of the great works of Johann Sebastian Bach. And lo, these centuries later, for us organists, and for many musicians, Bach's music remains at the heart and soul of our repertoire. Today we hear one of his great pieces, the Passacaglia and Fugue in C minor. I was going to play this in a program last weekend, and instead it comes to you today. As you listen to this piece, I'd invite you to think about the spirit of a passacaglia. It's usually a melody that happens in a minor key and in 3/4 time, kind of like a slow waltz. And as the piece begins, you'll hear that passacaglia theme played in the pedals slowly and surely, and that theme will repeat over and over and over again. And as it does, each time Bach will accompany it with another kind of brilliant figuration in his way, recycling and reusing that melody again and again in beautiful and unique and colorful ways. And we'll hear all kinds of different sounds emerging from the organ as we go. And just as a piece builds to what seems like a giant climax, it couldn't go anywhere else. Just then, Bach breaks away from the Passacaglia and takes the same melody we've been hearing over and over and makes it the subject of a double fugue, where the melody's in the right hand and then in the left hand and then in the pedal and then in between the two hands and on and on and on. If any of you have ever thought Bach is boring, you should try to play it sometime. There's a lot of fascination in the spirit and attitude of this piece and its brilliant structure, to be sure. Here is our main course for today's recital, the Passacaglia and Fugue in C minor of Johann Sebastian Bach. on so many of his manuscripts, it said that Bach would have written, writing music is an act of faith, and performing music is an act of worship. I hope that's come true, at least for some of us this day, in sharing this great music from this deep person of faith in this amazing Passacaglia. We'll end the program today with a musical benediction, a piece that's been beloved, particularly in this congregation, which is so beautifully played by this incredible organ. Before I end, though, I want to offer my thanks to my page turner, Brent Shaw, and to Ariel Merivale and Tom DiPerna, who have helped make the video possible today. So please join me in thanking them for their noble service behind the scenes today. And without anything further, my prayers for you and for your family, for your safety, until it's indeed safe for us to be in this holy sanctuary together again. Here, my friends, in benediction is Nimrod from the Enigma Variations by Edward Elgar.